This is Marie McCabe recording an interview with Miss Emilie Wiedenbeck for Historic Madison Incorporated on November 1st, 1983. This is a test. This is track one of a tape of an oral interview of Emilie Wiedenbeck on November 1st, 1983. This is Marie McCabe, and I will ask you to give me your name and spell it for me.
Emilie Wiedenbeck, and my address is 7523 Midtown Road, Verona. And the zip code is 53593.
All right, Ms. Wiedenbeck, you told me that your parents were early residents of Madison.
Yes, yes.
Can you tell me your mother's name?
Yes, my mother's name was Emilie Teresa Steinle.
Will you spell that last
S-T-E-I-N-L-E. Mm-hmm. And she married my father, whose name was Theodore Ernest Wiedenbeck.
And that's W-I-E?
D-E-N-B-E-C-K, mm-hmm. Yes. And if you would like, I can show you their wedding certificate, which is very beautiful. It's in my bedroom.
I'd like to see that.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And my father's wedding gift to my mother was a house he had built. It was at 308 North Hancock Street, which was just across the street from the pumping station.
Well, how did she meet your father?
I don't know.
Simply
because they were both very early residents.
Oh.
And they both worked in Madison. My mother custom-made hats. And my father, from a very early age, walked the railroad track from what is now Milwaukee Street to Madison. His mother didn't want him to be alone in Madison. So they knew the Simons, Maggie and Fred Simon, who had not only a hotel, but they had an apartment building. And so Maggie Simon mothered my father during the week. And then on Saturday night, he walked the railroad track home. His father was John Wiedenbeck. And he was a very strict, very cruel man. He was a brickmaker. And all the children, and they had a large family, all the children had to help.
Was this in Milwaukee?
On Milwaukee Street.
Oh, I see.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But of course, and there were no buses or anything in those days. So winter and summer, he had to walk from the square. He worked for Sumner and Morris, a hardware store.
Oh. Now, what was that name?
Sumner and Morris.
I see. Mm-hmm.
And it was on Pinckney Street.
I see. And Milwaukee Street then was out of the city.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, it was.
5 miles, something
yes.
like that.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yes. Mm-hmm. But of course, now there's a bus every 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And
So how did his family, do you know, happen to come to Madison, or the Madison area?
My grandmother Steinle came over here when she was 8 years old, and she worked in the house that was now a governor's mansion, and it was very unusual because it had indoor bathrooms and more than one.
Was this the governor's house out in
No.
Gilman?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. It became the college club later.
Right. Uh-huh.
Yes. And
she worked there in what capacity?
Pardon?
She worked there, you said.
Yes.
Was she a
maid? She worked as a maid.
Oh.
Uh-huh. And then met my grandfather, who was, he did everything. He sold real estate, and he was a butcher. And in those days, nobody ate brains liver and things of that sort. Those things were all thrown away. Even sweetbreads. But my grandfather thought that those were the prize part of the animal, so he'd bring them home, and my grandmother would cook them. They owned a great deal of property in Madison. They owned what is now Orton Park, and that had been a cemetery. And they owned a great deal of what we called Sixth Ward.
Well, how did they acquire that?
Bought it. But in those days, they bought things very reasonably. When I came out here, I paid $1,800 an acre for land that my sister and her husband had bought for $400.
Oh, there's a big difference.
Yes.
But your grandfather must have been quite successful.
Yes, he was. Mm-hmm. Yes, he was. Mm-hmm. And they had a large family. My grandmother was just a darling person.
Well, now, how did she get to Madison at 8 years old, you said?
Well, she came over on a boat.
By herself?
With her family.
Oh, uh-huh.
Yes. Now, my niece, Barbara Endres, has been in Europe and has written a genealogy of the family.
Oh, good.
Both her husband's and our family.
Now this is, the family was from Germany? The Steinleys?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And I think my father's mother was from Austria.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
But
I wonder, the Steinleys came, I wondered how they happened to come to Madison. Do you know, have any idea?
No, I haven't. I think they just wanted to come to America.
And they may have known someone in this area.
They might have.
Uh-huh. So they settled in Madison, and do you know when?
No, but Barbara could tell you.
Oh,
mm-hmm. I'll give you her telephone number, and she's one of the people that you should talk
All
with.
Right. Barbara.
Her name is Barbara Endres, mm-hmm. Endres.
Mm-hmm.
And her telephone number is 845-67. Mm-hmm. 28.
Fine. All right.
She lives right next door.
Oh, good. Well, but it was very early anyway.
Yes. But she can give you all the details.
Fine. And then your do you know you were saying your grandmother had this job in the governor's mansion. Do you know what her father did when he came here?
No, I don't. Uh-uh. No, I don't know anything about my grandmother's father and mother.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
But she worked in the governor's mansion and met your grandfather.
Yes.
Okay. Now her name, your grandfather's name was
Joseph Anton Steinle.
Mm-hmm. And what do you know her name before she was married?
Yes. Dorothea, I believe it was Langenecart, L-A-N-G-E-N-E-C-K. H-A-R-D-T.
That's a long one to remember.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay. So she was Dorothy, and she married Joseph Steinley.
Joseph Anton Steinley, mm-hmm. Yes.
And mm-hmm. together they bought the land.
Yes.
We were talking about.
Uh-huh. Yes. And they had a very large family, and I think I can tell you all their names. I believe the eldest was Joseph. Mm-hmm. And then there was George. And the youngest was Leo. And Leo worked for the Gisolt and was sent to Europe as their representative. And the man that went with him was a man whose name was Long, Freeze Long, F-R-E-A-S, Long.
Well, do you know the date? You had the wedding certificate, you said.
No, but I think that's what Barbara can give you.
I see. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. You have your mother and father's date. Now, there were just three boys in that family?
Let me see. I've told you George and Ed and Leo.
And Joseph.
George.
No girls?
Oh, yes. But I'm trying to think of the boys first. Mm-hmm. I believe my grandmother lost two children, stillbirths. Mm-hmm. And then I believe my mother was the eldest. Her name was Emily Teresa Steinley. Mm-hmm. And then she had a sister, a young sister, whose name was Catherine. We
C.
always called her Aunt Katie.
Oh.
And another sister whose name was Mrs. Mackey. And she married a Scotchman who was absolutely no good. And
his name was Mackey.
Mackey.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And they had a large family and a great many tragedies. Mm. Oh, I didn't tell you that my mother had a brother whose name was George. They lived on Jennifer Street.
Well, that's one of the boys you mentioned.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And his wife was Petula something. And they had one son and two daughters. And the son became involved with, some of the boys in Madison, Manchester, and boys that had a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And Clinton, who was just a wonderful boy, became involved in them, and he didn't have as much money as they did. So, very unfortunately, he wrote a check in his father's name and signed it and cashed it because he just had to do the same things that the other boys did.
And these are all Steinleys, then?
And, yes. Mm-hmm. And
you know where they live?
There are two girls, Laura and Helen, both married, and Helen had one daughter and didn't want another one. So she took something that would abort the child, and she didn't ask anybody. She didn't ask a doctor what to take, and she lost all her hair and finally died. Then Laura married a sailor, and they
this is
had
in the brother George's family.
Yes,
you telling me about
George's
him?
Daughter,
okay.
And they had no children. But they were both alcoholics.
Goodness. Do you know where the grandparents lived in Madison?
The grandparents?
Yes, the Steinleys.
The Steinleys, yes. They lived... The house is still there. I could show you the house. They lived in what was at that time called Schultz Park.
Emma mentioned that.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. And, it was a place where people went on Sunday and drank beer and
played
games. Yes.
And had band concerts.
And then they had a German band. And the umpty kind, you know.
Did they have a big house?
Fairly large. It was adequate.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Did your mother tell you about growing up there?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Uh-huh. She worked very early.
Oh.
And as I told you, she made custom-made hats. Mm-hmm. So all her life, even just before she died, she had beautiful hats.
Did she have a shop?
No. She worked for, I think, Burdick and Murray.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Which was a very early mm-hmm. store.
Mm-hmm. Oh. And
some of their friends on both sides were the Herfers.
Mm-hmm.
Is that name?
That family. Too,
yes.
Through
uh-huh.
these interviews.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And
are there any Herfers around still, do you know?
Well, there are some of the grandchildren, I think. The Herfers lived on Gorham Street.
Oh, mm-hmm.
And after we moved from Hancock Street, which was the first house that my father built for my mother. We lived at 608 East Gorham.
Oh, okay.
And we
that
always...
was near the pumping station.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And we walked to school, and in the winter, because it was on the lake, we walked through caves, actually, because the snow was so deep.
Oh. Well, do you know the date your mother and father were married?
No, I can't tell you offhand.
That's on your certificate.
Mm-hmm. But those are all the things that Barbara mm-hmm. can give you.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would assume that your mother married when she was 20.
Oh, I think she was 24,
uh-huh.
and there were she had four children, and one that was stillborn,
oh.
And her first child was Margaret, and she was Mrs. Blumenfield,
oh, yes.
And she was the one who died on the 7th of May. She was 90.
Last year?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was the second one, mm-hmm. and I never married.
And you're Emily. Do you have
yes.
a middle name?
Yes. I was the only one who was going to marry and have a lot of children. And I'm the only one who didn't.
No.
But as it worked out, It was a very good solution, because if I had had my own children, I would have taken care of just them. As it is, through my books, I've reached millions.
Oh. And you don't have time to do that if you
no.
have a family.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what was your middle name?
What was?
Your middle name.
Her middle name?
Yours.
Oh, mine?
Mm-hmm.
Mine is Emilie Agnes Wiedenbeck.
Mm-hmm.
My father had a sister whose name was Agnes.
Do you know what year your mother was born?
No, I can't tell you offhand.
Okay. But you were born what year?
I was born in January, mm-hmm. January 29th, 1896. Mm-hmm. Margaret, Mrs. Blumenfield, was born on the 27th of November, and she was 4 years, let's see, yes, 4 years older than I. Mm-hmm. And then Fran came next, Frances Moore. And she was born on the 21st of April, and she was 7 years younger.
Than you?
When I was, I'll go back and tell you something else.
Okay.
When I was seven, I saw a squirrel on a tree, and he was hanging by his hind legs, and I thought that was wonderful. And I called to my older sister, Margaret, and I said, oh, come here quickly. I want to show you something wonderful. Well, she didn't get to the window fast enough. So I said, when you pick up my feet, I'll put my hands on the windowsill, and you pick up my feet. And that's what the squirrel did.
Oh.
Well, I fell. Not very far. My father was sitting near us, and he said, oh, you're all right, honey. You're not hurt. So I took his word for the fact that I wasn't hurt. Then during the night, I was sick. And from that time on, I had a great deal of pain in my abdomen and my back, and the only way I could relieve it was to put my feet up on the rung of the chair and put my head on my knees. We had a wonderful doctor, Dr. Mack, and my mother called, and in those days they made house calls, and he came in he came with a horse and buggy, mm-hmm. and he always brought gum. He didn't want the children to eat candy because it wasn't good for their teeth. So we always got a piece of gum when they came. Well, he came time after time, and he couldn't find out why I was having so much